Hello everyone, this is Harshita Bhargav from Jitkara School of Hospitality, and in this session we are going to learn about profitability ratio. And in previous sessions we have learned about liquidity ratios, leverage ratios and activity ratios. So let's start with profitability ratios. Let's understand the meaning of profitability first. Here, profitability means abilities or capabilities of a business enterprise to generate profits or returns for the business. Here, profitability ratios indicates the profit earning capacity of a business. Accordingly, profitability ratios can be calculated either in relation to sales or in relation to investments and can be classified into two categories. First is profitability ratios based on investment, and second is profitability ratios based on sales. Profitability ratios based on investments. That means these ratios would tell us that how much profits or returns a business has generated upon their investments made in the business or capital employed in the business. And these ratios reflect the true earning capacity of the resources employed in the enterprise. And we can categorize these ratios into two parts. First is return on capital employed, and second is return on shareholders' funds. Return on shareholders' funds. It means that how much returns or incomes or profits a business is generating upon the investments made by the shareholders in the business. Accordingly, shareholders' investments are also called return on proprietors' funds. The formula for calculating return on shareholders' investment is net profit after tax and interest divided by proprietors' funds. Now, remember, we used to calculate our profits by deducting all kinds of expenses from total incomes. And at the end, we subtract depreciation, interest, and tax. Then what left with us is net profit. So we are talking about this net profit, which comes after deducting all kinds of expenses, including depreciation, interest, and tax. And this net profit would be divided by proprietors' funds or shareholders' funds. In previous sessions, we have learned about proprietor funds. I'll again summarize here about proprietor funds. Proprietor funds is also called as net worth or shareholder funds and is calculated by adding equity share capital, preferential capital, reserves and surplus, and all the accumulated profits of the business. And from this addition, we subtract all the fictitious assets and accumulated losses, if any. After this addition and subtraction, we will get our proprietor's funds or shareholder funds or net worth of the business. Now, this ratio is very important for shareholders because they are always interested in making returns upon their investments, and they would also compare their returns with the risk involved in the business in which they are investing. Next is return on capital employed. Now, this ratio would calculate that how much returns a business is generating upon the capital employed in the business. And this ratio is the most appropriate indicator of the earning power of the capital employed in the business and also acts as a pointer to the management, which shows the progress or deterioration of the earning capacity and efficiency of the business.
The formula for calculating return on capital employed is profit before interest, tax and dividend divided by capital employed. That means we have to deduct total expenses from total incomes to get profit before interest, tax and dividend. Here before signifies that interest payments to creditors, tax payments to government and dividend payments to shareholders have not been made yet, and that profit before interest, tax and dividend would be divided by capital employed. This capital employed would be available in the balance sheet. On the liability side of balance sheet, we can identify the items of capital. Accordingly, we can calculate return on capital employed. Ideal ratio is assumed to be 15%. If return on capital employed is equal to 15% or more than 15%, it would indicate the higher productivity and efficiency of the capital employed in the business, or vice versa. We have studied about shareholder funds in previous slides. Let's study some more facts about it. Return on shareholders' funds ratio is of great importance to all kinds of shareholders, whether they are present shareholders or prospective shareholders of the company, as well as for the management of the company, because this ratio would reveal that how well the resources of a firm are being utilized in the business. Higher the ratio, better would be the results. In this way, it will help to compare firms with each other, or this is called inter-firm comparison. So inter-firm comparison of this ratio determines whether their investments in the firm are attractive or not, as investors would like to invest only where their returns are higher. Under return on shareholders funds, first ratio is return on equity capital. That means how much returns or profits the business has generated on equity capital. And this ratio establishes the relationship between net profit available to equity shareholders and the amount of capital invested by them. It is used to compare the performance of company's equity capital with those of other companies and helps the investor in choosing a company with higher return on equity capital. Accordingly, the formula for calculating return on equity capital is net profits minus preference dividend divided by equity share capital. That means here we would take net profits after interest, tax and depreciation. We would deduct all kind of expenses from total incomes. After that, we would deduct depreciation, interest and tax. Now what left with us is net profit. From this net profit, we would deduct preference dividend. Preference dividend is that which is paid to preference shareholders because they are having preference over equity shareholders. So it is mandatory to pay preference shareholders first as compared to equity shareholders. So we would subtract that preference dividend from net profit and divide it with equity share capital. This equity share capital would be given on the liability side of balance sheet. So from there, we will take equity share capital and divide these two items in order to calculate return on equity capital. Higher the ratio, better it is for the business as well as for the shareholders. Next ratio is return on total shareholders' funds. Now, this ratio acts as a yardstick to assess the efficiency of the business operations and also indicates that to what extent assets employed in the business are utilized well, which results in net profits of the business. So, formula for calculating return on total shareholder funds is net profit upon total shareholders' funds. This net profit would be in profit and loss statement. From profit and loss account, we can take this net profit, and total shareholder funds will be calculated by adding all kinds of share capital in the business. Two major categories of share capital are equity share capital and preference share capital. When we add these two major categories, we will get total shareholders funds. And if there are some other categories are also given in the question, then we will also take them into account in order to calculate total shareholders funds. So we will divide net profit by total shareholder funds and we will get return on total shareholders funds. Higher the ratio, better it is for the investors as well as for the business concerns. Next ratio is earning per share. Now, this ratio means that how much earnings or how much revenues, how much profits a business is generating on one equity share. In other words, this ratio indicates the earning per equity share and establishes the relationship between net profit available for equity shareholders and number of equity shares. That means when we divide net profit available for equity shareholders by number of equity shares, we would get net profit available on one equity share or earning per share. Here, in simple words, we are calculating that how much we have earned, how much the business have earned on one equity share. Next ratio is dividend per share. Now, dividend per share, that means that how much dividend a business or a company is paying upon one equity share. EPS was different from this ratio. We should not confuse these two ratios. EPS was telling us that how much earnings we are making on one equity share. DPS would tell us that how much dividend a company is paying upon one equity share. Earnings are different from dividends paid. Company may or may not pay entire earnings to the shareholders in the form of dividend. Accordingly, the formula for calculating DPS is dividend paid to equity shareholders divided by number of equity shares. That means whatever dividend company has paid to the equity shareholders would be taken into account, and this would be available in profit and loss account statement of the company. From there, we will get this dividend paid to equity shareholders and we would divide it by number of equity shares. Number of equity shares would also be given on the liability side of balance sheet. From there, we can see how much is the equity capital of the business and how much equity shares are there in this business. So, this was about dividend per share. In this session, we have learned about profitability ratios based on investments. In next session, we would learn about profitability ratios based on sales. Thank you for watching this session. Bye-bye. Take care.